Hello everyone, I'm Hannah, an English teacher from Virtually Fluent, and this is our bite-size review on countable and uncountable nouns. When you see a noun in English, it will be countable or uncountable. There are some words that are both, but we'll see those at the end of this video. Let's start with countable nouns. Countable nouns are, as the name suggests, nouns that we can count. We can put a number before the noun. For example, one apple, two apples, three apples. We can insert a number before the word apple. Countable nouns have two forms, a singular form and a plural form. The singular form is used only when we have one of the item, for example, one apple. When we use the singular form, everything in the sentence must be singular. The verb, the pronoun, the demonstrative, articles. For example, the apple is red. There is one apple, so the verb is needs to be singular. And the plural form is used when there are two or more of the object. Two apples, three apples. And when we use the plural form, everything in the sentence must be plural. In this example, the apples are red. Apples is plural, so our verb are is also plural. So those are the basics for countable nouns. Uncountable nouns are completely different. They cannot be counted, they cannot be separated into individual parts. Words that are typically uncountable are liquids, gases, powders, and abstract ideas. For example, water. Water is a liquid, and you can't separate individual pieces of water, so it's uncountable. Because we cannot count individual parts of uncountable nouns, we don't have a singular and plural form. We only have one form, one word. But uncountable nouns always follow the same rules as singular countable nouns. So when you use an uncountable noun, verbs, articles, pronouns, demonstratives will all be in the singular form. For example, the water is blue. We know water is uncountable. The verb is needs to be in the singular form. As I said earlier, there are some words that exist in countable and uncountable forms. Let's take the example word chicken. If you're talking about the animals as pets, for example, it's countable. For example, there are four chickens in the garden. We are counting four individual chickens. But when we talk about chicken as food on a plate, for example, this is uncountable. It's an unknown quantity, and you can't separate individual pieces of chicken. For example, there is some chicken on my plate. There are lots of words that are both countable and uncountable. Sometimes there are also words that exist in countable and uncountable forms, but the meaning completely changes. For example, toast. When this is countable, a toast, this means a speech and to say cheers with a glass. For example, I will make a toast at the wedding. But when this noun is uncountable, it means a piece of bread that's been inside a toaster. For example, I would like some toast. So that's our bite-size review on countable and uncountable nouns in English. We do have an entire course on our website that goes into more detail about countable and uncountable nouns, as well as a long list of all the words that have different meanings when they're countable or uncountable. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and turn notifications on to see all the new videos we upload on a weekly basis. And you can also head over to our Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn accounts. I post lots of free content on a daily basis to help you learn and improve your English. This is Hannah at Virtually Fluent, bringing English to life.